The clear blue sky, the scent of flowers, the colors of rangoli and the sound of crackers, the gifts and sweets from the dear ones and the getting of their love, the light of candles below and the dazzling fireworks above, lightening lamps at our homes, making the less fortunate smile, putting on new appraisals and showing our friends our style, paying respects to the god and decorating for them the thali. This is what the occasion is all about. This is the festival of Deepavali. Now, I request everyone to get ready for the national anthem.
Janagana mana adhinayaka jaya hai Bharat bhagya vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
An exuberant good morning to respected Madam Principal, Madam Vice Principal, teachers and all my dear friends. We the students of class 12th are here to present the morning assembly on the special occasion of Diwali. Prayer. Prayer is a response from our hearts towards God. An outpouring of expression and internal feelings before God. I call upon respected Madam Vice Principal for today's special prayer.
A very good morning to all dear students. On the auspicious occasion of Deepavali, let us pray to Almighty. Om Sarva Badha Vinirmukto Dhan Dhanya Sutanvitah Manishyo Mat Prasadena Bhavishyati Na Sanshayah. O Goddess Lakshmi, you are Siddhi, nectar and purifier of the worlds. You are twilight, intelligence and faith. You are the science of dialects and gist of Vedas. The universe is filled with your gentle forms. On the occasion of Diwali, may Goddess Lakshmi fulfill all our dreams and desires. May we all attain perfection. May we be bestowed with wealth and fame. O Goddess, those who are glances upon by you are praiseworthy, accomplished, fortunate and powerful. May wealth and prosperity come to us. Health, knowledge, everlasting peace and freedom, all types of wealth will be ours. Bless us always with abundance and joy.
Scriptures is considered as the product of divine inspiration. Studying scriptures is like spending quality time with the God. We always make out time for the things we love, no matter how busy we are. And scriptures builds up and relationship between God and humans. So I call upon Monish Pawar for the scriptures of the day.
Today's scriptures are Ramahi Sumiran Randhrat Dekh Par Kripaye Tulsi Jahi Na Pulak Tanuta Jag Jeevat Jaye. I repeat, Ramahi Sumiran Randhrat Dekh Par Kripaye Tulsi Jahi Na Pulak Tanuta Jag Jeevat Jaye. Which means, according to Tulsidas, a person is living a miserable life if they do not feel excitement while praying to Lord Ram when they are on a battlefield against a worthy opponent and when they pay respects to their teacher. I repeat, according to Tulsidas, a person is living a miserable life if they do not feel excitement while praying to Lord Ram while they are on a battlefield against a worthy opponent and when they pay respects to their teacher.
Music is a piece of art that goes in the ear straight to the heart. Now, I would like to call Manya and Lavanya to present the special song. optimism and positivity are the important ideas that have the ability to make our lives better. However, they are not. Firstly, hope. Hope is an expression of our wishes that things will turn out well. It is an expression of our desire for a better future for ourselves and for others. It injects us with a reason to keep trying and perceiving. It has a strong and motivational impact on all of us. Secondly, optimism. Optimism reflects a tendency to look at things in a positive way and reflects an increased expectation that things will go well. It goes beyond. Lastly, positivity. Positivity is the idea that things will always work out well for us. No matter what the circumstances are, the outcome will always be right. With these words, I call upon Achal Tiwari for the theme talk.
Diwali is a festival of joy and prosperity, the celebration of the victory of good over evil. Let me tell you a story which will reveal all the reasons as to why this grand festival came into existence. Thousands of years ago, in the city of Ayodhya, there was a wise and good king named Dashrath. The eldest prince was Ram and was naturally the heir of the kingdom. One of King Dashrath's wives was jealous of Ram and demanded that he be exiled to the forest for 14 years so that her son Bharat be made king. Having once promised to his wife to fulfill any wish of hers, the helpless king exiled Ram to the forest. And so Ram set off on foot, accompanied by his loving wife Sita and loyal younger brother Lakshman. A few years into their exile, a demoness named Surpanakha saw Ram and fell for his looks. She asked Ram to marry her. Ram refused and asked her to go to Lakshman instead. Lakshman also refused. Enraged, Surpanakha showed her true form and Lakshman cut off her nose and ears. She went wailing to her brother, who was none other than Ravan, the demon king of Lanka. Ravan was furious and swore revenge. With the help of another demon, who took the form of a golden deer, he distracted Ram and Lakshman and kidnapped Sita from their hut. When the brothers returned, Sita was missing and they realized that something bad had happened while they were gone and immediately rushed to find her. On their way, they came across an army of monkeys and bears that agreed to help them. Among them was a monkey named Hanuman, who had once vowed to be at Ram's service. Now Hanuman was no ordinary monkey. He could fly over mountains, change size at will, and had superhuman strength. It was Hanuman who finally found Sita imprisoned in one of Ravan's beautiful gardens. He reassured Sita that Ram would be here soon to rescue her. He came back to Ram with Sita's whereabouts, and the army of monkeys, bears and men marched to the Lanka. Soon, a great battle started between the two mighty armies, and Ram's soldiers managed to kill all the demons, except Ravan. The battle was now between Ram and Ravan. He gave Ravan one last chance to apologize and set Sita free. Ravan instead rained down weapons on him. Ram too fought back relentlessly, but despite all his efforts, nothing seemed to kill Ravan. Finally, Ravan's brother Vibhishan told Ram that the weakest point of Ravan is in his navel. Using an arrow given to Ram by the gods, he shot Ravan in his navel and killed him instantly. And so, Ram and his love Sita finally reunited. Soon after, upon the completion of their 14 years in exile, Ram, Sita and Lakshman finally returned home to find the entire city waiting for them. The streets were decorated with flowers and lamps and there was happiness everywhere. And this is why every year on Diwali you see the streets, homes, offices lit up with lamps like the city of Ayodhya in celebration of Ram and Sita's homecoming. In addition to this epic story, every year we lay stress on going green during Diwali. Green Diwali is a way of celebrating the festival of lights with minimum damage to the environment. Celebrating Diwali in such a manner so that it may not cause harm to the environment is the essence of eco-friendly Diwali. As the festival takes the pace, the Diwali night is celebrated with bursting crackers. The crackers not only cause air pollution but noise pollution also. There are even cases of reported casualties because of crackers. As the country is suffering from the ongoing coronavirus pandemic, which is a respiratory disease, it is even more important to go green this Diwali, as the pollutants emitted by these very fire crackers lead to the formation of smog. And this smog assists the pollutant to suspend around our surroundings for even longer duration. This also leads to asthma attacks, bronchitis, and various other problems. So, on behalf of Delhi Public School Kolar Road, Bhopal, we request you to enjoy this festival by going green. Thank you.
Thank you, Achal. Now, I would like to invite the one and only dynamic leader who has been the guiding light for all of us. Our school has achieved many milestones under her able guidance. Now, I would like to request respected Madam Principal to enlighten us with her pearls of wisdom.
The strongest light is the light that shines within you. Use it to lead the way of your life. Greetings to all on the auspicious occasion of Diwali, the festival of lights. Dear children, this beautiful festival is spread over 5 days and each day has its significance. But what is common in all the days is the triumph of light over darkness, knowledge over ignorance, and the time begin to afresh. Be the light, spread the light, are simple but profound words, which simply mean that we have to shine from within and help others shine too. How can we do this? For that, let us understand the significance of light. Light serves as a symbol of life, happiness, knowledge, positivity, and prosperity. There are records of early man worshipping the sun as God, the supreme power. Hence, this festival teaches us that light helps us find the way of our lives. As we move forward, we should take others along with us so that together we can make things happen. I extend warm and heartfelt wishes to all the members of DPS Kolar family. I pray to the Almighty to send peace, prosperity, abundance, and joys to every household. May this year be happy and fulfilling for each one of us. I congratulate the students and teachers who celebrate the festival, who celebrated this festival in such a colorful and vibrant manner. Well done, my team, my students, my teachers. Dear students, enjoy the Diwali festivities and goodies. But also remember that we have to be kind to Mother Nature. That is very important. So stay away from polluting crackers and celebrate an eco-friendly Diwali.
Thank you, ma'am, for enlightening words. Now, I would like to conclude with these lines. Decorate this Diwali with the depth of relations, not with the heights of decibels and explosions. Let's spread the fragrance of mutual joy and laughter. It's unfair to pollute with the smoke of disaster. Let's make noise together when our country shines. Let's not annoy the neighbors with the unwanted sounds. Let's shatter the light of love and care. Let's illuminate the hearts with concern and share. Let's respect the 5 valuable gifts of nature. Freely available are fire, water, earth, space and air. Volunteer for safety, health and friendliness. In this way, Happy Diwali makes a true sense. Thank you.